City Lyon is a multidisciplinary research center which is designed to try to bring people of different medical, biomedical, chemical and hospital specialities together to try to speed up therapies into patients. So we work with people from all ranges of the university and the hospital and even pharmaceutical companies to try for the first time to speed up how we could treat a child with a disease that has not been treated before. So we have tried to look at children's diseases and children's problems in a different way. So for example, we work on a problem called cleft palate. So we work with a young surgeon in Switzerland who has worked with us to develop a technique to create bone from the umbilical cord of a newborn child. So if a child is identified in utero as having a problem with a cleft of the palate, then we can create bone from the child's cord and try to give that child a much better facial implant than they would have had before. Although you can treat these children using bones from other parts of the body, they tend to grow in a different way. And of course, sometimes you will get a shrinking of the bone, and sometimes the bone will not grow as fast as the rest of the face. So when the child reaches puberty, you have to do it again. So what we're trying to do is to create a much faster growing bone, a much more moist bone, much more like the rest of the child's face, so that when they're growing up, they don't have to go through more surgeries because it's traumatic. Unfortunately, sometimes when a child is born, they are starved of oxygen during the birth process and they get something called hypoxia. Sometimes this is very small and the child will recover, and sometimes it's very serious and the child will go on to have something we know as cerebral palsy, which will affect their mobility and affect their ability to be able to communicate with people. So what we have done is develop a technique to take cells from within the cord blood and put them into the child so that in the moments after birth, when they start to have brain inflammation, a heating up, a swelling of the brain, we can try to reduce that, and so the initial problems will be less than before. And we have gone right through all the preclinical stages and have applied for authorization from the French government to be able to do this on children. I think the most interesting possibilities with umbilical cord blood stem cells are those which will give a child a much better quality of life in the future. So today we can treat children with over 70 different types of diseases and disorders, and already there are more than 20 different clinical trials across the world with umbilical cord blood. Since umbilical cord blood is so easy to get and so easy to store, we have an ability for the first time to be able to store stem cells from the 130 million children born every year across the planet. So therefore, I think it's extremely exciting for the future of regenerative medicine to include umbilical cord blood stem cells in our treatment. I think in the future, people will understand that stem cells are not always about curing people, but also about increasing the quality of life. And right across the world, we have an increasing aging population. We're living longer than we ever did before. My grandparents in Ireland lived to 94 and 95, but it's suggested that today, by the World Health Organization, every child born today will have the chance to live to beyond 100. And I think that this is exciting, but it's also a problem. If people live to beyond 100, they will have more cancer, they will have more Alzheimer's, more Parkinson's, more strokes. So the excitement of stem cells is to be able to use those for the aging population to increase their healthiness and their quality of life as they get older. Thirty years ago, when I first started working with umbilical cord blood, there was only one or two diseases treatable. Today we have countless people that have been treated with umbilical cord blood who have blood diseases, and that was just the first 20 years. Today we're starting to see people be treated with genetic diseases, with skin-related diseases, and clinical trials in the fields of diabetes, bone disorders, brain-related disorders. So I think the future shows that although cord blood is not applicable and usable for every type of disorder, it is going to increase exponentially for the next 50 years.